I remember it was a lovely sunny morning, 25th of March, 1993, and we were a bit late that morning because I was sort of looking after the job for Gerry O'Kane and Mahara Fireplaces, and we had to go and get stuff on a plumber's yard down in Killaray, and we were fairly lit. I would say we arrived in the job about 9:02, and I remember us just pulling in, and as usual, we just parked along the side of the road, just reversed back beside a skip, you know, and I say the engine was just switched off in the van when this blue transit van came out of a cul-de-sac, and just the next street up, and it came down, and it came in round and reversed back, and it sort of jammed us in, you know what I mean? And we weren't, well, I don't know what was happening, it come in that fast, and then all of a shot, I seen the passenger's door opening, and this fella getting out, and heavy were bolt, and he came running up to the windy screen with a revolver, and he started shooting discriminately right around the whole windy. And I remember me, I looked at him, and you know, you'd have seen the windy just smashing in front of you, you know. I turned around to get onto the back, and there's a makeshift bit of plywood, you know, it took a wee while to get over the top of it, but I mind me getting hit here in the thigh, and I stumbled over the top of the plywood, and I fell on the floor, and there was nothing really to guide you or help you, you know what I mean, on the back of the van to cover you. So I mean, we lifted a vibrating plate that morning in Killaray, and you know the way the vibrating plate comes up like this here, and I mean me sort of putting my head underneath that there. So and I heard a bit of shouting going on, and the next thing, the sliding door beside me was opened, and they started to shoot and discriminate into the van, and I take it then that I was shot on the head then after that, you know. And I heard them round at the back door trying to open it, but they weren't fit to get it open because, funny enough, the back door on the old van were never closed right, so that morning when we had the vibrating plate on the van, it's a big heavy article, as you know, we tied the back door to the handles off the vibrating plate, you know, so they weren't fit to get the back door open, you know what I mean, so they just shot through it, you know. So at the back of the van there, up at the top, Noel O'Kane was sitting on one side, and Gerry Dalrymple was sitting on the other side. And I would say that what I think, they shot through the back of the van, and I think that bullet hit, there was only one shot in Noel, hit Noel on the back of the head, you know. And I remember me just getting out of the side door of the van, because at that stage, the fella that was with us, it wasn't in the van, he was sitting in his wee car, and the gunmen had left the scene, and he had come running down to me, and I stepped over the top of Gerry Dalrymple. He was lying gasping for a drink of water, so I take it he had been shot in the chest, you know, and look, everything was going haywire, and I sort of run up the footpath looking for help, and I felt the blood coming gushing, that was absolutely pouring out of me, and I just mind me falling, I couldn't go any further, and I mind me falling on the footpath, and then this woman stopped with a 205 Peugeot when she came across the road fairly fast, she seen me, and I mind her asked me what religion I was, and I told her I was a Roman Catholic, and she says to me, I'm going to say a wee prayer into your ear, and she said that to contrition into my ear, and I prayed along with her, and she held my hand then till the ambulance come, in the meantime, she was on the phone, you know what I mean? She had rung the ambulance. And that's really all I remember of it, you know what I mean? You know, they took me away fairly quick after that, you know?